Buenas noches, chicos, chicas, y chiqueses. Welcome to Araceli of the West. This is a friendly reminder to please silence your cellular devices. Hearing a Tinder notification go off in the middle of a ballad is kind of a mood killer. Oh, and unwrap any mazapans or Trujillo's burritos you may have. And remember, no flash photography. Be mindful of all the exits. Seriously though, this is a small performance space, so be respectful of those around you. We will not hesitate to use the champa. Enjoy the show.
Televisa presenta.
Superheroes.
Nah, that's too corny. Let's just call them heroes.
Sounds good to me.
And like all heroes, there is a tragic backstory involved.
Oh shit, this is a musical comedy.
It is, but there will be some dramatic elements for the sake of character. Antonio Valenzo and Alicia Valenzo, known as Golden Soul and Silver Luna, respectively.
Together they protected their Mexican pueblo of San Manuel. They beat up bandidos, then go home and eat tapatio on Doritos. Total relationship goals.
Eventually, the two had a baby.
Look at how beautiful my daughter is. She has a mother's eyes. Eyes that can make all of me go full safe.
There's Golden Soul with his newborn baby daughter, Araceli. Araceli means altar of the sky.
Y'all might be wondering, where's your mother, Alicia, Silver Luna?
Silver Luna had gone to visit family, while Golden Soul stayed behind to take care of Araceli.
It's a pinche musical, we can't have both parents in the picture.
While Silver Luna visits family, she confronts a dangerous villain, and in a heated fight, she's killed.
Her death shakes Golden Soul to the core. He is heartbroken. His fragmented heart begins to grow cold as he sings to the baby Araceli.
A hero never cries, a hero always tries. A hero has to find light in the dark. You have your mother's eyes, and one day you'll realize that the strength that lies within you can make a mark. I will wait you to have lifts up.
Antonio swears to train Araceli so that she will never meet her mother's fate.
17 years later, after the death of Silver Luna, Araceli has now become a beautiful young woman. And her father will finally give her permission to take down evil, just like her parents and their ancestors before them.
I'll be a hero, I'll have a chance to shine. I come from a line of heroes, and their blood runs in mine. With my sword in my hand, I will protect my town and land, and uphold my family's legacy.
Dirt roads lined with family businesses that have been there since generations. A church with a cross higher than any point in the town. Oh, and there are animals running about.
Like Marco, that horse right there.
Right there is Doña Lucrecia, Araceli's grandmother and Antonio's mother.
And there's Valeria with Liz. She's a student of San Diego State University.
Hey yo, Carlos! Carlos! Rebel that grill y regálame una torta de asada con frijoles, guacamole, cebolla, cilantro, y muy enchiloso.
Oh, and some chicken tenders for Sophie here.
Chicken tenders, Scott.
Vicente Fernandez tried to serenade me. Sometimes I can still hear him singing.
That's just the radio playing one of his songs.
Well, tomorrow night is open invite. No wallflowers, BYOB. Vamos a bailar, cumbias, banda, y rancheras. I even got this Christian Nodal impersonator.
Christian Nodal? Adios, amor, man. That song hits me.
Right here! Occasionally, dastardly villains try to stir up trouble, but Golden Soul, as vigilant as ever, is always ready to stop them. But today's a special day, because he's letting his daughter fight alongside him. He's ecstatic to see his daughter kick ass like him and his wife once did.
You'll not stop my excellent plan this time, Golden Soul!
You're crazy if you think I'm gonna let you get away with that chicken. You might have thought to make some delicious chicken tacos out of them, but you got another thing coming. The only thing you're eating tonight is chigazo with a side of pain. Right, mija? Your mother and I have kicked the Mexican of school more times than I can count. He's kind of an idiot. He's a good start.
Hold up. This is your daughter? Oh, warms my heart to see her interested in the family business. Hi, I'm an executioner, one of your parents' oldest arch nemesises. You know what I mean. I won't go easy on the daughter of Golden Soul and Silver Luna.
Okay, Whitey. An executioner causes a commotion like every other week. And even though Golden Soul is pretty ruthless with villains, an executioner is more of an annoyance than an actual threat.
Hey.
So let's go over your training. Introduce yourself to him tall and proud. By doing this, you let everyone know watching that you're intimidating him and ready to fight.
Executioner?
I
am Araceli Valenzo, daughter of Golden Soul and Silver Luna, and I will protect this town of San Manuel.
Woo! Yeah, Araceli, kick his booty!
Yes. But, you know, maybe we can just talk about why you do these bad things instead of just beating you up and throwing you in jail. Maybe together we can come up with a solution and, like, figure out why you do these bad things.
No, Mama, I told you, I don't have a wall to bring to the fiesta tomorrow. I'm single by choice. This is your daughter? Oh, what a joke. Tell me about it. I'm evil, mijita. I don't want to talk about my feelings. I want to tear shit up and burn it down. You really did a shitty job raising her, Golden Soul. Oh. I just pushed down your daughter. I insulted your parenting techniques. I'm really going to get it this time, ain't I?
More.
The owner of the white sedan, you left your lights on.
Everybody except for Araceli Maria Valenzo Chocobello and Maya, please leave.
Okay, Papa, before you get...
Why don't we talk about it? Why don't we talk about it? Araceli, what in Santo Juan Diego's huaraches were you thinking? All of this training teach you to be strong, teach you to be like me. And you just throw it all away. All you have to do is exactly what I taught you. Your hero debut was a disaster.
You said it was okay if I did things differently.
I thought you meant doing a spin kick instead of an uppercut or something.
I just tried to reason with him.
You can't reason with evil.
He isn't even that evil. He usually just does some petty crime and then you go machista on him.
Machista? Machista, Mama, are you hearing me?
Evil, calm down.
I am a hero. I fight to protect this town, and when it comes to protecting what you hold dear to you, you can never back down. Your mama, she would have whooped him. What would your mama think of you now? I'm disappointed in you, Araceli. That's all I'm gonna say.
I didn't do anything wrong!
You didn't do anything right either!
Adios.
Mija, no llores. You come from a long line of heroes. And I'm telling you this because I know one day when you're older and strong, you'll look back on this day and remember how weak you were. And you will be proud of how much you have grown. Now I need to go apprehend the executioner and put him back into prison.
I really messed up, didn't I, Juanita?
Gonna keep a room with you?
Yeah.
It kind of blew it up there, but it's okay. We do silly things our first couple of fights.
Your papa, he's only being hard on you because he wants you to be strong. Preciosa, hermosa, bonita. Let me pass on some family wisdom that my mother, your great-grandmother, told me back when I was a young girl. She told me to be like the eagle on a cactus.
The eagle on a cactus? Like the one on the Mexican flag?
Yes. Don't you know the story behind it?
Of course.
Good. I'm still going to give a quick diverged version just in case someone happens to be listening in on our conversation. The Aztecs were a wandering people looking for a new home. They had a legend that said their new home would be marked by an eagle perched upon a cactus devouring a snake. Well, one day, as a man was walking, he saw the exact event that was prophesied. An eagle on a cactus with a snake in its beak along a swamp. The Aztecs made this their home. Strong, powerful, an unforgettable image. To the Aztecs, this was a sign of strength and power. Selly, you need to be that for San Manuel. You need to be a symbol everyone can look up for comfort and strength.
I don't know, Abuelita. How can I be even close to something that strong?
Selly, here's something you may not have been. Every mountain once was a stone. So let me tell you a secret.
Everyone except for me, I guess. It just skipped my genes. But one day the town will adore me. They'll cheer Araceli from the crowd. I'll be like the heroes who came before me, and I'll make my whole family proud. I'll be known across the land like an eagle on a cactus, standing tall on sword in hand. And yeah, watch me attack this. I can handle the heat and the thorns at my feet. And with the hopeful heart, my story will start. And I'll be like an eagle, like an eagle, like an eagle on a cactus. A hero never cries, a hero always tries, a hero always rises to the test. Sharpen my claws and ride and attack, then fly, then I.
gonna tell her what she needs to hear.
Damn!
The way you brought up her mother?
She's my wife. I can bring her
over. Do not raise your voice at me.
See, Mama.
Yeah. Oh, Pete, sorry. I'm not gonna tell you how to be a father. Oh, wait. Yes, I am. Cabrona was her first fight.
If you could call it a fight, she tried to reason with him. Mama, she nemesis is.
You know kids nowadays in the PC culture. So it's a little too empathetic and sensitive nowadays. Personally, I've been reggaeton music, but you and I need to understand these are different times.
A hero never backs down. She needs to be strong, Mama.
Damn, this is getting kind of intense. I think I'm gonna escape real quick.
I'll just put him back in there next week.
I thought training was going well. What happened?
I wish I knew. Everything was going fine. And she was even able to keep up with me. And she was even able to perform our family's ultimate move. The 100% Rasa Smash.
The 100% Rasa Smash? That's a dangerous technique. It leaves every part of your body in weak spot just for one superpower punch.
She could do it. So it's not that she can't do the things I'm teaching her, it's that she doesn't want to.
She probably gets it from Alicia. She was soft-hearted too.
I know. She reminds me of her mother so much. And which is why I need to change her. If Alicia was stronger and less than...
Antonio! Do not look in the past. All we have now is the future. You don't need to be empathetic to villains, but you need to be empathetic to your own daughter. Get on the same page and open up to her.
That would be a sign of weakness. And I am not weak, Mama. Where are you going?
To my own Marcella. To make sure this year's guest list has Jose Alfredo Jimenez, who's superior to Pedro and Frankie recently. Just you gotta respect the process. If I don't do this, this guest is gonna be filled with Gomez and Isel, Cardi B, El Jugar Frio. I'll see you at the fiesta. You know, maybe you and I need to think about what it truly means to be strong. And leave now.
Being strong, you can never shed a tear. Being strong, you can never cower. You keep your mind clear. You never show fear. When you're strong like that, then you have power.
You fight every foe. You look at danger and go, standing strong even in the darkest hour. I don't want her to meet your fate. She needs to have nerves of steel, which is why in her I must cultivate.
Fuerza, fuerza, con fuerza no tienes dolor. Fuerza, fuerza, con fuerza no tienes amor.
So I raise her, so she can match you. She can withstand the shock, have her stand firm just like a statue, and have a heart as hard as rock. And I can feel my core crumbling every second you're not here. And in a way I find it humbling, but I refuse to shed a tear. A hero never cries, a hero always tries. A hero has to put the past to rest. Well, I'm built within my eyes, and I can disguise them, but I have I have to hold it in with all my fuerza. Fuerza! Fuerza! Fuerza!
Everybody's Mexican. We're 30 minutes late.
here is my unpaid intern, Chad, from Chico State University.
Open fiesta!
That's my last spring break in Cancun. But yeah, I'm Chad. I'm a third year business major at Chico State University. Member of the Campus Republican Party and a proud brother of the Kappa 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 fraternity.
What do you trust fund white boys want?
You calling trust fund white boys, Grandma?
Get that guy over there shooting them not on the short policy up here in San Manuel.
Well, unfortunately, ma'am, I have some bad news for you all. San Manuel is now an American territory. Everybody who isn't American needs to leave. Sorry for the inconvenience. None of you are moving. We put up an eviction notice earlier today. Let me see.
Dude. Obviously, they only speak English. They can't understand it.
Okay.
I got this. I got a D+ in my intro Spanish class with Chico. Somos Americanos. Please, leave us. Gracias.
Why should we leave? We have lived on this dirt for centuries. What is the issue?
Wait, everybody, let's calm down. Service seems to be the problem. I'm sure we could all come to understanding.
Oh, well, finally, some basic human decency around here. Well, as you may know, when the Treaty of Guadalupe was signed after the Mexican-American War, it gave us a lot of the Southwest. You know, Mexico sold us modern-day Texas, Arizona, New Mexico, California, Manitoba.
Sold being the flexible term.
And thus the treaty ended the war. But a few weeks ago, while a historian was analyzing the document, what was long thought to be damage to the treaty was discovered to actually be a salsa verde stain. So, in our technology to remove the stain, we discovered that we have one more tiny little province right here. So, with orders from the president himself, we have come to reclaim it.
Oh, okay.
Tell them that they don't suck it!
Do not disrespect my president like that, and you can suck it because we are taking San Miguel back.
Your president is an idiot for thinking he can just send some goofy-looking chumps up here to take our town.
I could be a much better president.
And what do you mean, take it back? It was never yours to begin with. Get out of here, you Anglos!
Whoa! That's racist!
Yeah. Okay, so let me get this straight. You can call us Anglos, but if I were to call you dirty, salsa slurping, churro chopping, horchata chugging, wetback, then I'd be the racist one?
Yes!
What? Me? Racist? Yeah, right. I saw Black Panther. And this one time, I got head from an Asian girl in an army bathroom. Don't go assuming, okay? Because it just makes an ass out of all of you and me. And Ming gave some pretty good head.
Leave this town or else!
Or else what, you old fart?
Forget them, the whole boy, they're gonna be at the
window! Whoa, stop yelling! Feeling a lot of tension right now. So let's just cut to your race and cut to the chase. How many of you are legal?
Well, technically, just me.
Asians in Mexico?
Well, Chen, you must descend from the influx of Asian immigrants that came to Mexico during the colonial period.
What the frick are you talking about? That's not how I got here.
Well, how did you get to San Manuel?
Well, it's a story better expressed through song. You delayed me! I'd like to tell you how a patient came to this town. duper messed up.
Vigilante? No way. I am Araceli Valenzo, daughter of Golden Soul and Silver Luna, your worst nightmare.
Well, Araceli.
This is the last line of defense for San Manuel. A little kid. Where are they anyway?
Golden Soul and Silver Luna, now that would be a fine play. All that's left is this half-baked hero.
Half-baked? Oh, honey, let me show you. I'm ready to get cooking.
Well, even our comebacks are mediocre.
Yeah. Oh, no! I'm so scared!
Wait. I'm not scared. You should be scared.
I can't feel my legs. Why can't I feel my legs? What kind of brujería is this?
I'm sorry. You might be strong, but you can't fight my magic.
Yeah, take that!
Nice, boss.
There's nothing you can do.
Araceli, are you okay? Who are you?
Papa, be careful. They're here to take someone well. She's using some type of brujería to control people.
Listen here, fiend. I have little patience for people who come from the north. You have no tolerance for this town or the people in it.
This coming from the most brutal vigilante in all of Mexico who beats the Pope out of petty criminals on a whim.
The heroic Golden Soul. Yes. I must say, I was a fan of you and Silver Luna way back when. How is she, by the way?
Well, according to the report, she's been dead for about 7 years.
I know, you idiot! I was provoking him!
If you know who I am, and you are aware of my reputation, you must be some special kind of stupid to speak to me like that. I know your kind. I do not want to listen to what you have to say. I do not care about your motives. But today, I'm feeling unusually calm. So I will give you the option to leave now, or I will beat you to within an inch of your life. Chingado! Everybody leave!
As San Manuel is frozen in fear,
I said go!
Araceli runs off and heads north toward the mountains, with Guaco right behind her.
Round him up and put him in the processing center.
Do you want us to follow that girl to the desert?
She knows what's good for her. She won't come back.
I thought you would be stronger. But you're easy to control too. Take a good look at your hero, San Manuel. Golden Soul? Powerless. Can't even stand up. And his pathetic successor just ran off. Your town has been conquered and your protectors defeated. The era of Mexican vigilantism is over. Conquered by the fist of American justice.
Araceli rides Guaco in the desert for hours.
Until she finds herself at the U.S. border.
Where she passes out.
And is taken into a mysterious
facility. By an even more mysterious woman.
I just want to make
you
up. Go on right now.
What?
If you want to be in this country so bad, you should be glad we're even letting you be here!
I have no idea where I am.
Typical leftist move. This gobbledygook Indians are going to be blind. Look at her scream! Aunt Yelani!
The beautiful, innocent Tommy Lasagna?
Sweet Ronald Reagan from above. I have the patience to not slap this bitch on fire. We're in a camp specifically designed for people who cross the border.
You better let me go or else.
Or else what? You gonna slice me in half with your sword? My sword, where is it? Not only did she illegally enter the USA, oh no, she brought a sword to me. Wait, what? These liberals are so vocal on banning guns, and they let my chorizo chips come slinging in their samurai jack toys. The left is too busy jacking themselves off to their samurai ideology. Just to show you, I'm not messing around. Aurora, bring out the horse! Quacko!
He's nothing like the fine stallions I saw in the American Girl movies I watched growing up.
Take her to her cell, make sure she behaves. Tomorrow night, do black lives really matter? Oh, it's gonna get too darn hot here on the burn.
That was a great show. The daughter of Silver Luna and Golden Soul on my, in my I might get some views on this video.
I didn't look back. I'm such a coward. My mother would be so disappointed.
believe she was still alive. Damn.
Whoa, you're like a superhero?
No, that's too corny. Just say hero.
You know, it's okay to feel sad.
No, it's not.
Why is that?
A hero never cries. A hero always tries. Heroes don't give up and run away to who knows where. Heroes don't break down. They don't go and leave their town. Heroes have wisdom. I don't have wisdom.
Who said you can never be scared? You can never cry?
My papa told me that. It's what his mama told him.
I have fuerza.
Senora, I don't mean to sound rude, but...
How can you say that?
You're a weird, emotional old lady who's stuck in this cage. If any of us had fuerza, we wouldn't be here.
You sure are set on being alone. Can I offer some advice?
I guess. Take a deep breath, take the strength you need to protect yourself. Recollect yourself. How did you get here? What did you do? What part of your heart was passed down and what part of it's you? Regardless of what you've been taught, recover, rethink, and realize that you can do what you want.
I don't understand what you're trying to tell me. And how can I just disregard everything that my family has taught me?
You don't need to disregard their teachings.
They tell you things and I tell you things. Take what they know and take what I know and take what you know and mix them.
Let me tell you a secret. Being strong isn't the absence of weakness. It's admitting you have weaknesses, but not letting that stop you from doing what you need to do.
I am strong because I carry on through a world unforgiving. I am strong because even when I cry, I just keep on living. I'm pushing forward and going toward
when you go to
Regina?
No, let me explain. See, you can send the man back to Mexico, but wouldn't it be better to keep the man here and send the Mexican back to Mexico?
You're doing an evil monologue? Really? Starting it with the rhetorical question?
Hey, man, you're lucky you only have to hear it once. I mean, she's done this with every single person.
Yeah, you're lucky she isn't singing it.
You see this here, Belt?
It's time not to. It's absolutely it.
That's what I said.
This belt gives me psychic abilities, specifically mind control powers. I have the ability to remove and alter parts of the mind, but my powers are limited. The effects last for only a few hours, and then the mind reverts back into its normal state. See, the original plan was to deport you all, but that was before I came up with a solution. A permanent solution.
You're gonna kill me? Mama, I'm sorry!
I said that was the original plan. But that was before we finished our secret to weapon.
Secret weapon?
Lo and behold, the whiteout.
Dun, dun, dun!
This has the power to lock a mind permanently once I manipulate it.
This is like a bad episode of Black Mirror.
So what are you gonna do with my mind?
I'm going to take out the Mexican and put in something a little bit more American.
My way.
No, my way.
Activating the whiteout. Do your incantation.
His mind and rearrange. Oh, wait, all the
spells and Brujeria will not work on me.
They will soon.
You will never take away who I am.
Needed to.
I see. Will San Manuel be okay? Will Captain Ten Republicans release a statement saying this play is racist? Let me go over our amount of time for this face.
Find out next act on Araceli of the West!
Folks, viewer mail time again. Oh, here's one from Sally, age 14. Dear Pig, aren't you interrupting the story at the most suspenseful part? Well, the answer is yes, Sally. Yes, I am. Keep those cards and letters coming.
Meanwhile, back at San Manuel.
All right, San Manuel. It's time for the daily song.
I hate the daily song.
Excuse me?
Oh.
I said, I can't wait. Daily song. San Manuel used to be a center of Mexican grime and crime, but it's been hugely improved with just a little time. Isn't it peachy keen when everyone's the same? Everyone is peaceful, everything is tame. It's all right now. It's all white now. Hit it!
They no longer eat guacamole.
Speak for yourself, I have a solo in it.
You have to sing the song.
attack?
The spell?
Yeah, it's all part of Lori's magical belt. She can have mind control powers and stuff. That's why everyone's American now.
Chad, don't go airing out all our laundry.
Relax, we don't, even do laundry. Only gays and Democrats wash their clothes. I guess so do you. When I wanted to rap all the lyrics in Gold Digger.
This is 2019, Sophie. You know, America's changed a lot. You know, ever since Trump enacted the 50th Amendment to the Constitution, English is the only language we can legally speak.
Since when?
Since Trump tweeted it a month ago.
You can tweet laws now?
Yeah, ever since Trump enacted the 34th Amendment to the Constitution. Oh, hang on. Twitter notification. New law coming in. Here we go. Pollo Loco is terrible, awful service. I hereby announce the 54th Amendment to the Constitution, decreeing the total and complete nuclear elimination of all 430 of their franchise locations.
What the heck, Anolis?
Jeez, you have been gone a hot minute.
Something about this isn't right. I can't believe other Americans are trying to take away my right to be me. And I can't believe other people would just stand around and let them... light bulb. I'm the bad guy.
No.
We are the bad guy.
No, Sophie, we are. This is a good thing.
Yeah, I mean, it's fair game. You know, Mexico signed the treaty. This town belongs to the U.S. I just don't think about it too much. But if you do, just think about it this way. We're helping these people.
Yeah, you know, it's like karma! You know, for all the bad things Mexico's done to the U.S.?
Yeah, I mean, remember the Alamo?
Remember the Titans?
And what about all those illegal Mexicans that come into the U.S. and they take jobs and they kill people? I mean, just last week I saw a post on Ben Shapiro's Facebook that they talked about an illegal Mexican that killed somebody. What about that, huh?
But hasn't America done bad things to Mexico, too?
Well, yeah, it was just bad things for the right reasons.
My head hurts.
Think about it like this, Sophie. If you look for the bad in something, then, you know, of course you're gonna see it. But, think about the good. Then that's all you'll see. So just do that.
No, ignore the bad stuff and think about the good stuff. Got it.
See you later, Sophie.
Later, skater. Oh, wait. One more thing. Do you like Arby's?
Yeah?
Awesome.
I feel I'm so conflicted and confused. If only there was some way where I could express these heightened emotions in a theatrical manner. I know. I'll write a song. Or take direct action.
Meanwhile, back at the IAIC.
Oh, I hate this prison cell. I can't stand being here. All they have on this stupid TV is Lifetime and Fox News. This is no way for people to live. If you want to live, you have to survive first. Do you think any of us like being here?
Remember, be silent, be strong, and carry on.
What is the point of carrying on if we're not carrying on to anything? We can't just sit around and let them do this to us. Tommy doesn't care about how we feel or anything, and neither does this puta right here. I'm tired of being here. I can't stand it. I can't stand watching them all suffer. I can't stand it. But when I look at you, I see my family, my time. And I'm not just saying that because of the obvious double casting.
from the people who conquered and those who fought against them. It's incredibly strong. It takes everything from your body, every muscle, nerve, bone, and blood, and puts it into one concentrated punch. It's dangerous, though, because it leaves the rest of your body weak for a brief moment. But the punch is so strong that it doesn't matter if the rest of your body is weak, so long as you can land it.
That sounds dangerous. How can you justify leaving all those weak spots just for one superpowered punch?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. Maybe you can have weakness and still be strong. I am a hero, and a hero puts their life on the line to save whoever they can. We are getting out of here.
What about us? We're not heroes.
Yes, we are. Anyone can be a hero.
Here's something I've learned as I've grown. Every mountain once was a stone. So let me tell you a secret not very well known.
I'm so
Maybe I can go to Broadway.
They love white people!
Before we move on to the next scene,
it's us.
The Dorothea twins. And we have something very important we want to talk to you about.
Yeah, we're totally not stalling the next scene so the actors can get ready.
We want to talk to you guys about something so urgent that it affects 1 in 4 Latinos across the country.
Yes, you or a loved one could be diagnosed with PCS.
Pinche Cordero Syndrome.
As your Latino friend, been acting a little off lately.
Do they blow off seeing Marco Antonio Solis in concert with you to go buy tiki torches with their white friends?
Did they change their name from Jose to Joey? From Juan to Cornelius Buford III?
Did they vote for Trump even though their grandparents were undocumented?
Your friend might be suffering from pinche culero syndrome.
PCS causes the patient to lose their culture, identity, and their sense of basic human decency.
And worst of all, their sense of all things raza.
Just like San Manuel right now, but in the real world. There is like hope.
There is like a cure.
Remind your friend of what life is like outside of their post-colonial thought bubble.
Take them to a King Taco.
Sit them down and have them watch Selena or La Misma Luna. Take him to go see Coco this April 30th in the Student Union, sponsored by AS. Thank you, AS, for letting us use great spaces such as this one.
Shut up, tamale after culo.
You can help him.
It is not too late.
So if you or a loved one is diagnosed with PCS, please call 1-800-951. Don't be a pinche cordero.
We'll send you a special Mexicare pack.
Each Mexicare package comes with a CD of Jose Alfredo Jimenez's greatest hits, an Aztec calendar, a tiny piñata, and a $10 gift card to Nord Market.
For only $500 cash.
Hey, now back to the pinche play. Meanwhile, back to the play.
What if they're in Michoacán, or Sinaloa, or TJ?
Relax, Marcelli, put your sorry butt together.
Carlos? Oh my God, Carlos, I'm so glad you're okay.
Hi, how are you? It's Carlos you speak of.
Dude, cut it out, where is everybody?
I am Carl. Nice weather we're having.
Reservations at our new Chili's Bar and Grill. Join us in our savings home.
Oh, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Can we see your papers? I'm sorry to ask, but you're looking a bit exotic.
My arm, Marcella?
What did they do to you?
May I see your papers?
¿Qué pasó con San Manuel? What is going on?
May I see your papers?
May I see your papers?
May I see your papers?
Hi, welcome to Chili's.
I'm pissed at you. You left us all to be deported. You're a piece of mierda.
What is going on with San Manuel?
I'm not exactly sure what happened. Everyone's under some type of mind control. It's that lady's bell. That's all sorts of her psychological psychic powers. Just as I suspected. I pay some money, but the effectiveness of the bell has to do with a person's mental state.
It's so obvious. No one would just casually go around wearing a belt like that in public.
She's using that belt to out the Mexican out of every Sacramento citizen. They're all like homogenous robots now.
That culture vulture.
It's worse.
A white lady came to the town and she built a spiritual fruteria right by the cemetery.
A called Cassidy. What is this?
I don't know, but San Manuel is going to look a lot like Barrio Logan, and they even replaced all the beer with Mike's Hard Lemonade. Anyhow, they need to sing this stupid song! And when they're not singing that song, they're singing Macklemore or the National Anthem.
Sounds about white.
But the good news is that we found out that her bedroom is in the processing center. The problem is her goons guard it.
We can easily take out her Pillsbury dildo or clip. We can't get close to her without getting her mind boggled.
It's hopeless.
There's nothing we can do.
She's lying. Can't fight.
We can't there. That's why we have to fight. We're all heroes. I believe you were a great hero way back when.
That was years ago.
Hey, if you've taught me anything, it's that there is no expiration date on being a chula, chingona, y cabrona.
Damn right! Valeria, Sophie, don't you guys want to be able to live in a town where you can be exactly who you are? No laws or rules to stop you from existing as Mexican or anything else?
Of course. What does y'all say?
We can never stop trying to make the world a better place, even if it means fighting. I got just the thing, Mia. Abuelita, where did you get that gun?
Someone was at U.S. They basically give these things out like goodie bags or something.
Okay, well, we're gonna do our best just to do this without violence, okay?
Mija, you said it yourself. Look, what's the capinera?
We're gonna do things a little differently. Quick, rest the huddle.
Come on! Absolutely not. Yes, stop.
No.
BLT. issue of Rat Digest.
You know, my airman bro, we heard you really have a thing for exotic chicks.
Well, you know, I like my women like I like my coffee. Mixed, preferably accessible to my mouth.
in order to get one of those under the border mouths, you gotta know how to dance. That's why we as fellow brethren are gonna teach you some poppin' Latin dance moves. Luke here will be a partner.
Dancing with dudes? Sounds a little gay to me.
Nah, man, it's teaching you to dance with a girl, therefore the gay cancels out.
Right.
Yeah, all right. Let's teach you some bachata. It's very sensual.
Ooh, one of my favorite senses.
Thank you.
the most wonderful treaty. Not only did Mexico pay for the wall, but we even put this kick-ass moat around it. You're still in your dreams!
Not a silly. Why am I not surprised? They always come back for revenge.
I reckon I should have killed you when I had the chance. But I tried to be a team player. I tried to be a nice scout. And you took that kindness for granted. I'd run off and never came back. I had a feeling in return. Just the way to get rid of you, Addison. I've done my fair bit of research on Mexican culture, and I have devised a diabolical death for you. One that will shake the savage Spanish conquistadors to their core and make the Aztec sacrifices look like arts and crafts. When inspired by one of your very own brutal party traditions. Que lo muero. Gasp! I will slam your face into this cake with the force of roughly 1,000 bitty-bitty-bomb-bombs. That's not just to any cake. It is laced with sulfuric acid and dynamite frosting. The second your face touches the cake, it will melt off and your body will burst into flame.
Our belly is spelled with an I, not a Y.
One thing right today, Chad, is that too much to ask for?
You know, this is a really elaborate way to get rid of somebody who might not have come back.
Oh, Anthony, come out.
Yeah. Papa, I'm so sorry.
Papa, I'm so sorry. Shut the fuck up. I couldn't de-Mexicanize this dude. His mind is too strong. But I figured that watching his daughter get blown to bits might crush his spirits. This is good evil.
Stop it, I'll do whatever you want.
You know, that sounds like a great deal. But I'd rather blow your daughter to bits and then get you to do whatever I want. One of the greatest heroes of Mexico. De-Mexicanize. You know, I can feel evil influence coming on. Sell golden soul, you're under my control. I have no doubt you've lost it all. And what you'll realize is that though the sun rises, the sun has to fall. You have no fuerza. Buenas noches.
No! Wait a second! Shh! Woman!
At least our beloved town of San Manuel and have destroyed the minds of those who live in it. You have disrespected my family and my town, and for that you must pay. You are evil, a special kind of evil that kills the flesh slowly by removing the soul. When you take away the identity of a town, you destroy the culture. You destroy the people. You ruin the past. You ruin the present. You create a doomed future, and I will not let that happen.
Why are my powers working?
Because your powers rely on them to affect the mind. You use the uncertainty and doubt to manipulate them. But it's not going to work on me. That's why you haven't been able to de-Mexicanize my papa. He's a hardhead, just like me.
How strong are you?
I am Araceli Valenzo, daughter of Golden Soul and Silver Luna. I am the rose that blooms
the end of your camino. And considering the things that I've experienced, the world would be better off if I could slit your throat right now.
What are you gonna do? Kill me? Go ahead, Asami.
No. I don't think you're as evil as everyone says. In fact, I think I figured you out.
Hold on!
Now, wait, 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 1 second. Hang on. While we were tied up, we realized how captivated we were by those fresh Latin beats, and we somehow ended up watching a BuzzFeed video on Latin American history and Paulo Freire's Pedagogy via Press.
What the fuck is a
BuzzFeed? As it turns out, the U.S. is responsible for many of the conflicts that have happened and are still happening south of the border.
Yeah, I mean, who would have thought that unjustified prejudice against Latinos is actually very prevalent in our American society and is caused by xenophobia and the long-lasting scars of imperialism and colonialism and a variety of other factors?
Caesar, we were too blind by our internal prejudice to realize that what we were doing might be wrong. And we failed to even consider that we might be the bad guys.
You made it seem like we were doing a good thing by erasing Mexican culture, but it turns out it's pretty, como se dice, chingón.
Yeah. We quit!
Yeah.
What quit? What do you mean you quit? You need this money to pay off your student loans. How are you gonna get the ka-ching ka-ching?
Wait, we don't need your ka-ching ka-ching, so ka-ching a tu madre.
Damn it, damn it, damn it! Everything was going perfectly! As I was saying, I think that you
should. Oh, so as a white privileged male, I think that I deserve a lot of praise for doing the right thing. You know, I think I might even be the hero of this story.
Dude! Ah! Shut up! I'm glad you learned a lesson that should have been common sense. But I'm talking! This issue didn't affect you directly, and I know my shit. So zip it! As for you, Lori, you're not really white.
Yes.
Yes, I am. What are you saying, Araceli?
I mean Araceli.
There it is.
I've been saying Araceli this whole time. Oh, and not to mention...
Ah, I can't look! Is she bald?
No.
And...
Ah, I can't look! Is she ripping her eyes out?
No.
Sky blue contacts.
Yes.
You're one smart one, Pam. I'll give you that. A Mexicana. It's not Lori. It's Lore. Loretta Gomez.
Yes!
Mexico, no way!
If you were really evil, you would have already killed me and my dad. So why are you like this?
Okay, hold on, Mom. Is it faster time? My arthritis is killing me. I'm gonna sit down. Whew. Anybody wanna do money? Well, it all started back when I was a young girl on the mean streets of the Inland Empire. Like Marietta? No, Marietta. Oh. My parents were Mexican immigrants from Jalisco. Spanish was my first language. When I attended school, I struggled with English, and the punk-ass white kids would call me names like Cheesebean. White on the outside, but brown on the inside. Looking back on it, the insult wasn't very clever, but it still hurt. So I rejected my Mexican heritage. I left my family, I stopped speaking Spanish, and I decided I needed to become something different. And I joined a group of people that would mistreat others without any negative repercussions. The American government. And when I found out that they were taking some, well, my heart felt pity for those that would be deported. And I figured that the only way to save them was to change them, to make them normal, to make them right. But I'm sorry. I'm so sorry that happened to you, and I wish it hadn't, but you don't get to decide what makes someone right or wrong.
You can grow, but that can't separate you from your roots. It's okay to change, but you can't force other people to change. And you shouldn't reject your heritage just because someone doesn't accept it.
Even if that's true, it isn't the reality. You must know that. You can be on the right side, but the others always think you are wrong, even if you're on the right side.
She's got a point. Here, hold this. Mihai, even if we get rid of Lori, we'll send someone else to come take someone love. And then they'll get rid of us too. Araceli, we can win this battle, but we'll lose the war.
Right? I am Mexican. If you want us to exist as Americans, let us exist as Mexican Americans. We'll eat hot dogs and go to NASCAR races, but let us watch episodes of El Chavo and listen to Tigres del Norte very loudly at 11:30 p.m. on Sunday night.
Mexican American? It contradicts itself. How can I be two things that are so different?
You just be. They're not mutually exclusive. You can be Mexican and American. You just find the compromise, the middle ground, like how you can have weakness and still be strong.
Yeah, you can be this or that, but you don't get to decide where or what other people can be.
You can be a melting pot of different feelings and ideas. You just take what's in the past and what lies in the future and create a better present.
So, I can be Mexican and American.
Of course.
So, I can like girls and boys?
Come here, big boy.
I'm not. Chad worked together to create the ultimate workout, combining Zumba and CrossFit.
Coming to a gym near you.
Leo created a local theater scene that rivaled the likes of Broadway and the San Diego Rep.
Our 2019-2020 season includes new works such as Machete the Musical, Alejandro Hamilton, Dear Evan Hernandez, and The Hunchback of Micho Akan. Along with old classics such as Evita and the 2008 Tony Award-winning musical, In the Heights!
Sophie and Valeria moved to San Diego together and got married. And Sophie became a Spanish teacher at SDSU. She wrote the textbook and charged $500 for it. Not including the custom $200 clicker. But she donated 100% of the proceeds to the Border Angels.
I love the razor.
She means Raza.
Donald Trump accidentally resigned through a tweet, and Antonio Lucrecia ended up winning the 2020 election as a third party candidate. Changed national anthem to Pásame la Volte.
And no one ever kneeled for the anthem again.
Turns out socialism does work if we don't install evil dictators.
Ari embraced Mexican American culture, and she'd ride down the boulevard in a lowrider singing Sabor a mí.
Antonio and the executioner finally just talk instead of fighting. Turns out all the executioner wanted was a compa to chill with.
I'm so happy I finally have a friend to play Armando Smash with and watch soccer games.
Good Chivas!
Go America!
They still found common ground.
Go Cruz Azul!
Shut the fuck up!
All the Mexican immigrants in the IIIC made new lives of themselves, along with Roar.
After recording a vlog, Tommy Lauren crossed the street and got hit by a truck of American flags and died instantly. Determination of Fuerza, Araceli became the greatest hero in the Americas. She had a live concert on Univision with Beyonce, Shakira, and Hologram Selena.
Even Lin-Manuel Miranda wanted to write a musical about her.
I would have said yes, but he wanted to play me in it.
She even got her own shoe brand, Air Aceli's.
But don't forget, she got to do what she wanted to do most of all.
Make the world a better place.
My daughter, you are the greatest hero in American and American history.
Our hero. I couldn't have done it without you guys. When I have you at my side,
come tomorrow.